So it's been 3 months with this midnight blue M3 MacBook Air. And let's just say it's been an interesting ride. When I first got this laptop, I thought, finally, a MacBook Air with a 15-inch display. It's slim, light, and has the sleek midnight finish. But 3 months in, I've got some thoughts. Good, bad, and the slightly embarrassing. At first, it was everything I expected. A bigger screen on a MacBook Air. Perfect, but over time, the honeymoon phase started to wear off. Let's get real, with just 8 GB of RAM, this machine has limits. I've tried to push it, 3 Chrome windows with roughly 30 tabs each, a Figma app with 4 to 5 tabs, Visual Studio Code and a Pixelmator project, all of those open at once. And that's when the stuttering begins. It's not terrible, but it's noticeable. And for anyone doing pro-level multitasking or some light video editing on CapCut, yeah, you'll start to feel those 8 GB constraints pretty quickly. The 512 GB SSD, let's just say, is just enough for now. It gives me the freedom to install my main apps, keep a handful of larger files, and still have some breathing room. But when I'm recording a screen, saving a video project, and doing any design work, I'm constantly towing that line of running out of space, you know. It's a bit of juggling act, honestly. For budget-conscious pros, this SSD size might work, but just don't expect to go wild with like some heavy storage needs. Now, I have to talk about the midnight blue finish. It's stunning, and I get a lot of comments and compliments from my friends and colleagues about the beautiful look of this Mac finish. However, this thing, as you might already know, is a fingerprint magnet. I can ignore it when I'm working solo, but every time I show it to someone, yeah, it can get a bit embarrassing. And I'm not even going to mention what happens when someone else touches the Mac with their hands. It can get messy. Sometimes you just have to ask yourself, am I willing to wipe this thing down every time I pass it to someone? Yeah, it's a small detail, but one you'll notice over time. Now, let's talk ports. This MacBook Air gives you 2 USB-C ports, MagSafe, a headphone jack, and well, that's it. No HDMI or SD cards. For the pro on a budget like me, it's all about the dongles. I have to rely on adapters for my external display and a card reader. It's manageable, but definitely not ideal if you're used to having these ports built in. Realistically, 2 USB-C ports can feel limiting, especially if you're multitasking with external drives, monitors, or other peripherals. But hey, if you're fine with a few workarounds, it's doable. One thing I absolutely love about this MacBook, it's portability. Even with a 15-inch screen, it fits like a glove in a bag made for a 13-inch laptop. It's like getting the best of both worlds. Screen space and ultra portability. For anyone who moves around a lot, the slim design makes it easy to carry all day. That's a definite win. Well, what about the battery, you might ask? Apple claims this can last up to 18 hours. In my experience, it's solid for light tasks, watching videos and web browsing, but throw in some video editing or heavy multitasking, it drops to maybe 5 hours or 6 hours for my tasks. Well, it's great for basic stuff, but if you're planning to push it, keep that charger close. So, after 3 months, would I recommend the 15-inch M3 MacBook Air? Well, here's who I think it's for. If you're someone who wants a large, beautiful screen and does light to moderate tasks, this MacBook Air is a fantastic choice. It's got that iconic Apple design, it's lightweight, and it'll handle day-to-day use with ease. For example, if you're a student or an office worker who mainly uses spreadsheet and presentation apps, you're definitely good to go. Beautiful display, lightweight and portable, and good for basic multitasking. Limited by 8 GB of RAM, which can be upgraded to 16 GB, easily smudges and requires adapters for additional ports. But if you're a power user on a budget, someone who needs to run multiple heavy apps, do some serious video editing, or rely on ports without dongles, you'll definitely hit some limits with this setup. you will at least need a 16GB version, though it gets you closer to that M4 MacBook Pro base model, which now starts from 16GB. No more 8GB base version for pros. That's a well overdue request, I guess. Well, overall, this MacBook Air is perfect for the just right crowd. It's a great blend of power, portability, and style, but only if you know its limits. So would I buy it again? Well, for my needs, yes, but only if I'm limited by budget and tired of working from a 13-inch laptop my whole life. What about you? Think this MacBook Air is a fit for your work, or would you go with something else? Maybe a Pro? If you found this helpful, hit that subscribe button for more occasional tech reviews and maybe some social media tips. See ya!